Our first class, as I mentioned, was in Phoenix. That's the altar. Very nice. There's Kathleen, Crystal, Fortune, Lizette, and Douglas Jackman. Mary Tapiro with the picture that Mario gave us. In a circle, we were outside at the noonday hour when I believe Helios came, so we talked about solar gazing, etc. There's Wayne and Michael, Jeanette, Teresa Latour, Jackie Police, Jackie Fleeter, Tom Miller, Jackie's daughter, I believe. There's Uncle Kenneth and Deborah Lamore and me. There's Philip and Uncle Kenneth and me. Uncle Kenneth talking with Kendrick Lassiter behind him. That was a little bit from the first class. Then we went to Washington, D.C., and I think that's, let's see. Well, Deborah, Carol, and there was Helen. Helen Fainer was there. Mario under the Capitol. Maria and the Iwo Jima Memorial. I've been there. Pretty cool. Then we had our One Touch of Venus event in the Twin Cities. I don't even know if that was mentioned by me earlier. I don't think it was on the list, so we'll have to...
It was a Meru event.
Yeah, this was a Meru event, and it wasn't on our list, but we did it. It was put on by Tom Miller primarily with help from Lisa Delaney and I believe Donna Driggan. It was an opportunity for Tom Miller to really share his legacy of his creativity, of what he's done throughout his life, with a lot of amazing alchemical works. So we had Donna Driggan, Brian and Carla Sweeney, Alona Iris, Maria, Jackie. There's the whole group. Gloria Rojas, Celeste Miller, Patricia Carlson, I've seen Alice Tucker. This is Diane Lasky and Nancy Barnum, and the gal from the Twin Cities, I'm choosing to remember her name. Then we went to Brazil, the Easter Conference of Bahia.
It was eight days. Like another
pilgrimage. It wasn't 3 days, it was longer. So there's Gwendolyn and Deborah. Wow, that was quick. Bozeman, this is our World Freedom Conference. I think it was one of my favorite conferences of all time. We had so many new products. We displayed the new Afra framed original by Marius Michael George. We had lots of beautiful statues. There's Maitreya. We had so many new things that we consecrated them all to Alpha, who dictated during that class. There's Deborah with her beloved Afra framed up. We had great amount of people at that event. It was just magnificent. So much light invoked. We did the Victory in the Holy City. Here are the Moryas, Chilas, and their blue turbans. Sam Guccione, Mr. Lightsaber Man. Here's the children's program play with my daughter and Jackie's daughter. Some of the Canadians. This is Lois Hollerman, who ended up, I think, leaving the area going to California. Anita Wolbird gave a presentation, I believe, since it was dealing with the children and youth.
Hooligans.
There's the hooligans, Boyd. And and as entourage, Kathleen joined Philip and Boyd. And there's Edward and, let's see, oh gosh.
Yeah,
there's Greg and Mascari at the bookstore. Edward again. Warrensby, that's it. Warrensby. And Deborah. There's Edward relishing the food with Richard. Somebody that looked like I had a big hairdo. There's Prashant Shah. And I think that's Nancy Batten. There's our beloved Nancy, now an Ascended Lady Master. Nancy with her husband at the time, Tony Von Arks. Elizabeth with the Fanuzzi family and Maria. 4th of July under the pavilion in Bogart Park. And John Delaney gave a fantastic speech that he gave in high school that won an award. It was Gregory and Paul and Janice again. We had a lot of fun that day. It was very warm, very hot, probably in the 80s or maybe in 90. Here are the Canadian gals, including Caroline Dunnigan and Martha Manns. Here's the Vera Choir with Gilles. I'm introducing them, and there's Gilles, the conductor. Sophie, probably their top soprano. Our beloved sister, Natasha Kolsar, the leader of their community, who's since passed on. These are the youth. They had a great time together. There's Sophie. Gosh, was that 8 years ago? Wow. Leon Lal Singh, Paul Ali, and Prashant Shah. They all have some tie to India, I think. Then our European pilgrimage. First we went to Greece, and then Crete, and then Italy. There's Marcia under the Acropolis. What a beautiful view. There's the Parthenon. Is that the name? And Martha again, Emma Dakel, and Sarah Sagai, and Lisa Delaney. There's Luke setting up his video. We drove a lot on a bus. You'll see the Violet bus pretty soon. It was great. There's an outdoor amphitheater where you could hear the person talking in the center of that from virtually anywhere because of the sound acoustics. It was awesome. A lot of plays, dramas, oratory occurred. I see Scott Moss, and I think Carol Rollinger was on that one. There's Raphael, feeling the vibe. There's that violet, purple, pink bus that we enjoyed. Paul checking out the formations and the records. There's Deborah, the Fitches, with Deborah and Stitches, as usual. The other Deborah Lamour and Crystal Fortune, Tatiana and Paul Ali. Oh, the bus driver showed us a dance. That was a lot of fun. And Gloria really enjoyed it. Gloria went wild, I think. There's a couple guys getting down, or maybe getting up. Paul Ali and Warren Wallring and others. We had fun. Dancing is fun. The gal in the white, I can't remember her name. What's her name?
Ida. She went to Brazil, too.
She went to Brazil. She was quite a dancer and yoga teacher, I think. There's Carol Rollinger with Marita, Michael. There's one of our guides. And that may be on Crete right here. Or it could still be in Greece. Very knowledgeable gal. And I think we... going to Delphi soon. Delphi, however you pronounce it. That could be Carol's husband, Roy. Or it could be me. I'm not sure. I had amazing memories and records, remembrances of being at Delphi before. What a view. Awesome. Then we went to this sacred monastery, and I think I saw Angela. There's Paul and Janice. It was a little chilly there, up in the mountains. This was a sacred day for me. There's Rena, Marita, and Saint Germain dined with us that night and made a toast to the divine director's twin flame. That was Lisa in her epic purple. I love that color on her. And some ruins. Paul and Janice and our tour guide with Lenore. John Fanuzzi taking pictures. Famous Russian iconography. There's Carol and Lenore with a view in the background. We stopped. There's Angela. Oh, it was Thermopylae. That's the king of the Spartans, Leonidas, who was an embodiment of Serapis Bay. Then we said goodbye to the bus driver, and we went to Italy. Italy was fantastic. John enjoyed it a lot. There's Janice teaching. I think it was on the five crystal rays. I think this was actually in Crete, just so you know. I don't think it was in Italy. That may be Deborah. We were doing chanting of some type. I think this is Assisi, so St. Francis home for quite a while. It was a magical place. And we walked a lot. It was fantastic. Many churches, one larger, major church. Walked the streets. And I think, as I recall, maybe Saint Germain dictated. I'm not positive. It was right there in the square. We had one or two dictations, and then a blessing. We went down into the kind of the crypt area where a number of Saint Francis's brothers or friars are buried, and I was one of those guys. I think we're heading over to Rome now. There's my beloved Mother Mary in gold. The Vatican. It was quite a tour. We had to wait for quite a while to get into the Vatican. You can see I did have a beard back in those days. It was salt and pepper rather than all white, so... Now it's all salt. There's a fountain, I believe, or a statue, Pallas Athena, I believe. Lots of works by Michelangelo and the great Renaissance masters in Italy, especially in Rome and Florence. We didn't go to Florence, but part of the Vatican Square, I believe. You can see the dome there. I don't know if we show pictures here, but we did go into the... Michelangelo's famous Sistine Chapel. You had to be quiet. There's the Pietà, probably Michelangelo's most famous sculpture besides David. Lots of little outside cafes in Italy. Their pizzas are very thin. Different than we have over here. Was that David? There's Tatiana. Renee, Palali, Sarah, and Prashant with Deborah behind them. There's Marita enjoying a espresso.
That looks good.
This was the... what was that called? The Pantheon. That was an amazing building. One of my favorite places that I've ever been on the earth. That's, I think, called the Oculus, which is... It's open at the very top in the center of the dome, and then we placed our feet right at the point right underneath there. There's our elemental friends producing beautiful fruit in the markets. Some ruins where I think there were some battles. You see the Colosseum in the background. The ruins of it brings back memories of gladiator days and Christians fighting for their lives. If you're a tourist, don't scratch anything in that area. Don't mar the surface of anything or take anything. There's Moses, I believe. It's our group out in nature under a beautiful... Is that bougainvillea? Somebody would know. Then this is the last thing that I think Mariette slides. There was a Wellspring Crystal Grid, Caroline Wyndham, who I think is originally from Great Britain, came and kind of led this sacred drawing of a circle, and then we placed... I wasn't there that day, but they made a kind of a grid and then placed crystals all over, and she does this around the world to energize things. There's Nancy and others of the local heart friends from the immigrant area that participated in that. So you can see it went very, very quick, and I wasn't able to name all the people that I saw.